about to pop my open mind cherry, so I hope you bought me a drink. This could get emotional. No, seriously, I'm a bit emotional. I've been in this interracial relationship for a few years. And I found out just recently, she's just Canadian. She's not even French Canadian. So she's just like boring white, which is a problem. I know that sounds mean, but you might have noticed, but I'm boring white. And it sort of feels really pathetic because there's this scale, right? Like interesting people to talk to at a party. Goes from 1 to 10. Number 10's like professional comedians, like Chris, he's pretty interesting. Neurosurgeons, they're really interesting. And then there's the bottom of the rung. I'm not quite there yet. It's reserved for Australia Post workers and coffee baristas who don't have beards. Charlie, that one's for you. No fucking beard. But I'm a banker, right? So that's like, I'm almost at one. I think I'm just getting out of one, to two, which is like missionaries with the lights on. But if you've seen with CBA at the moment, bankers can be pretty fucking interesting, right? You can be into money laundering and terrorism funding, which is fun. Like, think about it. You're at a party talking to a dude who's literally going to go to jail any week now. Like, unless you're from Logan, which that'd just be like a Sunday barbecue with the family. That's pretty fucking cool. But I don't want to go to jail, so I was like, I'm feeling pathetic. There's nothing interesting about me. I know what. I've got that like role-playing game night that I do on a Thursday night. I've got that level 12 Paladin. I was like, that's pretty cool. But when I looked into it, you know, it could have been an elf or a dwarf or a half-orc or something. No, it's just a human. I was like, fuck, not even my interesting characters are interesting. My imaginary characters are interesting. So fuck it. I don't know what you're thinking. This guy's a bit of a dickhead. Elves can't be paladins. No, I know that. I was just trying to make a point. This is awkward enough as it is. This guy's got a little 12 paladin, I think. You know how, like, in the 4th edition rules, that changed, though? So that's pretty cool. You can be an elven paladin now. So I'm a bee stick away from a midlife crisis, as you can probably tell. And I've looked around, and it seems like you do this long-distance event when you get to that point. You know, you climb a mountain or swim a channel or some shit. So this morning I was like, we're going to run a marathon. Probably taking you about 3 seconds to realise something that took me about 8 hours. Probably never going to run a marathon. So I was like, thinking about it, but a marathon is a lot like life, right? When you start, you're with your mates and you're G'd up and you're like, guys, we're going to do this. We're going to set a personal best. It's going to be awesome. Let's do it. Then you get to the midway mark and it's like midlife crisis time. They're like, dude, you're fucking boring. Don't want to hear about your D&D character anymore. And so they all fuck off. So you're just running this thing on your own, and then you get to the end, right? It's like old age. You can't feel your legs. You're like wobbling around. You're like, fuck the race. Fuck the personal best. Got one goal. I just want to get home without shit in my pants and pop it. Not like yesterday. No, but as I said, I don't want to go to jail. I'm clearly not going to run a marathon. So I was like, what can I do? So I had this premonition. I'm just going to start peeing outdoors. Like, that's going to be my thing, right? I'm going to be like, I pee outdoors. Yeah, I'll pee off things, you know, like park benches and rocks and stuff. And I might start a Twitter feed. I'll like, pee on flora and fauna. I might name it like that. Like, fauna's animals. For you guys that probably didn't get that joke. But, so I'll pee on things. But I've had a few complaints, right? Not from the neighbours or anything. They're cool with it because they're just boring white dudes like me. But no, from my wife. She's like, you can't do that. That's disgusting. It's like, come on, babe. I've got nothing left. Like, you're just fucking boring white Canadian. I'm like, just give me this, will you? She's like, no. If you do that, I'm going to come and squat next to you and I'm going to pee on the grass too. It's like, fuck, touche. Psychological warfare, I like it. So I've started Operation Passive Aggression. I just stopped mowing the lawn. Let's see if that tickles a fancy. No, but seriously, have you noticed, like, so I've been a bit depressed, right? So I've started trolling, you know, fail videos and stuff like that, made me feel a bit better. And then that just leads to porn videos. But have you noticed, like, some of those websites, this guy's nodding again, like, you get that ad and it sort of knows where you live and it knows the surrounding suburbs. And it's like, you're looking for a good time. Brackenridge. No one's going to give a shit in Brackenridge. Funnily enough, I found myself in Brackenridge Woolies that arvo. It's like, hey, Woolies. And there's like all these yummy mummies walking around with trolleys full of what only can be described as man lure. It's like nacho cheese Doritos, Tim Tams, Kraft cheese singles, of course. I'm like, well, all of a sudden I'm getting hit on too. I'm like, fuck, this feels good. Midlife crisis, getting hit on. This is fantastic. But that frozen food section, it's pretty fidgety. It's just cold reception down there. I recommend it. All right, that's me, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.